Good afternoon and welcome. You may be seated. These are odd times, and as I was walking in, I was smiling ear to ear behind my mask, and sadly, none of us are able to share those smiles, maybe a little later at our conclusion. Archbishop Hebda, Principal Passman, members of the faculty, parents, guardians, special friends, joining us remotely by live streaming, and especially you, the class of 2020, welcome and congratulations, we made it. Parents and grandparents, guardians, thank you for sharing your families with us. We have missed you all these past 5 months, and we will continue to miss you when today is over. Members of the class of 2020, I congratulate you again and thank you for all the contributions you have made to Cretin-Derham Hall. Your class has been shaped by adversity. None of us saw this coming until obviously it was too late. Yet we adjusted swiftly and made the most out of something none of us wanted. I want you to know how thoroughly impressed I am and we, the adults at Cretin-Derham Hall, with your positive attitudes, resilience, and ability to overcome hardship. History tells us that those who come to age during times of great adversity end up making tremendous contributions and impact on their world. Impacts that probably would not have happened otherwise. Your faith, education, and the opportunities offered to you by your families and CDH position you well for the impact you will make in the years to come. Be bold and courageous. The world needs your idealism and resilience. The pandemic will end, hopefully soon, and you will be ready. Our traditional prayer invocation, "Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God," is especially important today as we gather in this majestic house of God as a group, sadly for the last time. And you missed many times of gathering, and for that we are deeply sorry. As you go out into the world, you will be called upon daily to love the dear neighbor without distinction. And imagine what a world would be if we did that each and every day successfully. This is our challenge. As men and women of God, go forth and practice this daily. In a few moments, I'm going to ask the Archbishop to say a special blessing. But I'd like you now to stand and for one last time, after 4 years of saying this every morning, I'd like together to say the peace prayer for our families and for our world. Please stand. And I know that after 4 years, most of you know this by heart, and it may be a little muffled with your masks on, but I ask you to say it out loud. Let us remember that we are in the holy presence of God, and let us love God and the dear neighbor without distinction. Lord, make us an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me so love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. It is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Blessed Brother James Miller, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever. You may be seated. It is my honor to welcome and introduce to you a person that you are all familiar with, Archbishop Bernard Hebda. Archbishop Hebda began his tenure as our Archbishop by celebrating his installation at our school. We were honored to host him then, and we are honored to host him today. We thank you for your spiritual leadership and for being so generous with your time. I invite you now to lead us in prayer. Thank you for being here.
Let us continue our prayer in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all that is good. We bring to this festive occasion hearts filled with gratitude, grateful for this afternoon of celebration, and grateful for the abundant blessings that you have poured out upon these soon-to-be graduates, and the blessings that you will bestow upon your church and upon your world through the class of 2020. And yet we dare to ask for more. We ask you to strengthen with your steadfast love all the students of Cretin-Derham Hall, as well as their families, faculty, and benefactors. Bless in a special way the members of the class of 2020. Help them to remember always what they learned and experienced at CDH, to cherish the friendships that they formed and the core values that they adopted. Bless these, your daughters and sons, with the strength that they will need to carry forth the traditions of service, faith, and family that are the legacy of the Sisters of St. Joseph and the Christian Brothers to this fine school. And finally, O Lord, bless all who are gathered here, all who are participating virtually. May we grow in your love this afternoon and always. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good afternoon, and congratulations to the class of 2020. I want you to know that I am very proud of each and every one of you. Those of you who are here with us, I'm proud of, and those who are at home watching, I'm proud of you too. At this time, we recognize in a special way our top academic graduates. These students earned the highest grade point averages in the class of 2020. This year was unusual because we had a three-way tie for number 10. I will name the students starting with the number 10s and finishing with the class salutatorian and class valedictorian. Each student should come to the altar to pick up your medal, and then I ask the group to please hold your applause until all the students have been recognized and the salutatorian and valedictorian have been named. So starting with number 10s, Olivia Esch. Ian Machado. Annika Van Ostrom. Elijah Awada. Hannah Conroy. Isabella McDonald. Anna Maria Cullen. Cecilia Ziegler. Olivia Kala. Elizabeth Patterson. The 2020 Class Salutatorian, Matthew Stika. And the class of 2020 valedictorian, Benjamin Craighead. I have to say, I've never heard you this quiet in my entire life. Now you may give a round of applause to the top 10 graduates. And they can go back to their seats now. This year, the class of 2020 selected Emma Schold to be your class speaker, and we will listen to her graduation speech now.
Welcome to the class of 2020. Cretin-Derham Hall faculty and staff and loved ones. I realize that today looks a lot different than we dreamed it would, and I'd be lying if I told you that this speech turned out exactly as I dreamed it would. But as I grasped for the right words to say, I kept stumbling back to this quote. What lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters compared to what lies within us. Ralph Waldo Emerson. Random quote, right? Bear with me, it won't be anything like self-reliance, but I promise it'll be worth it. What lies behind the class of 2020? 3.5 years of love, laughter, and lanyards, 1 basketball state championship, 4 state awarded performances, 3 justice trips, 1 potential lawsuit from Travis Scott, and way too many theater homerooms. Today is the first day of the rest of our lives. That being said, I couldn't tell you what lies before us. I keep hearing that the class of 2020 will go down in history as the class that graduated during COVID-19. But I think we can do better than that. Because what lies within us are some professional grade athletes who are going to take the sports world by storm, 2 handfuls of dedicated performers, artists, and art enthusiasts who will see to it that self-expression never goes out of style, and quite a few of the most gifted minds to pass through Cretin-Derham Hall, including the brightest of all, Paige Bullis. She was the best of us, and her abundance of love will be with us today and every day for the rest of our lives. Today looks a lot different than we dreamed it would. The last 4 months were not what we dreamed at all. Are we ready for what comes next? Standing here, thinking about my last 4 years with the class of 2020, the class who will go down in history for being strong, hardworking, motivated, genuine, and united. I think the real question is the world ready for us? Thank you. Welcome to the class of 2020.
I was a little nervous there. I thought we were starting it all over again. So at this time, I would like to introduce your faculty speaker who was elected by the class of 2020. So if you will give a round of applause to English teacher extraordinaire, Mr. Hugh Hawkins.
Thank you. Well, here we are, finally celebrating the class of 2020. In order to understand and appreciate this unique and remarkable class, we must first examine the year we have endured and overcome to get to this momentous day. While you've spent 13 years in education and 4 in high school, it is this past year that has been in many ways the most challenging and perhaps the most memorable. This has been the year of peaks and valleys, of state tournaments and lost seasons, of traditional performances and online adaptations, of excitement in the next step and uncertainty in any future, of embracing new challenges and of losing loved ones. This is the year of Paige Bullis, and we celebrate her today and are eternally grateful to have known her and shared in her life. And this has been the year of Corona, of social distancing and online frustration, and of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor, of the largest worldwide civil rights movement, and of justice denied, justice delayed, and justice hopefully delivered. This has been a year that has captured our attention and demanded a response. This is the year of 2020. We might not have seen a year like 2020, and it isn't finished yet, but we also have never seen a class like 2020, and you are just getting started. The great Frederick Douglass once said, "If there is no struggle, there is no progress." It might be said that the year 2020 defined this class, but I think rather that this class was built to face the challenges and struggles of this daunting year, and to rise above to arrive at this moment, primed for whatever the future may hold. Because you see, I know many of you, and you have inspired me, and I know that your future will be full of purpose. This is best stated in the Bible, in the book of Jeremiah. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." Take those words to heart. You have a purposeful, promising future. So what does that future hold? Well, this moment feels like a culmination of everything you've experienced for the past 13 years. But the story isn't ending. In fact, it is really just beginning. From this point on, your journey will be determined by your decisions. You no longer need a bell or a teacher to tell you when or where to go. This is the part where you finally get to write your story and live your journey. You see, many will tell you that in the next few years, you will change and discover who you really are. However, I tend to agree with George Bernard Shaw, who said life is not about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. What a phenomenal idea. There is massive power in creation, and in this life, your life, you get to create yourself. And there are no requirements you need in order to be qualified to create. So pick up the proverbial pen and write your story. You already have a brilliant, likable, heroic main character, and I, for one, cannot wait to read the stories of your lives. I want to leave you with this final thought. The mathematician Archimedes once said, "Give me a firm place to stand, and I will move the earth." Well, your years of education inside the classroom and outside it, as well as the formation of your faith and friendships and family, have established a firm place, a firm foundation for you to stand on. And so today, on this day of days, as you stand as an individual and hear your name called, and again when you stand as a class and celebrate, stand firm in this place. Recognize your progress in the face of struggle. Create yourself, write your story, and go out there and move the earth. Thank you.
Before we present the diplomas to the class of 2020, we want to take a moment to recognize one of your classmates, Paige Bullis. While Paige died this past November, she is still very much a part of this class. She was a good friend to many of you, and you to her. We know she will continue to live on in your hearts. Paige's parents, Paula and Rocky, are here with us today and will come over shortly to receive her diploma. We will also recognize Paige by reading her name in her rightful place among all of you, the class of 2020. Please pause after Paige's name is called to remember her, along with the smiles, laughter, friendship, and love she gave to all of you. Paige, we miss you today and always. At this time, I would like to ask Paula and Rocky Bullis to come forward to pick up and receive Paige's well-earned diploma. Our hearts go out to both of you, Lauren, Blake, and your entire family. We so appreciate your generosity as you share this afternoon and sacred time with all of us.
Are you ready for this? I will now present and hopefully pronounce correctly the names of all of our graduates. Reminder that we do have many folks who couldn't be with us today. We will announce all of their names, so please wait for your name to be announced. Beatrice Ahern. Joseph Acco. Vanessa Alfaro. Olivia Amon. Darby Anderson. Grace Anderson. Isaac Anderson. Jonathan Anderson. John Anglum. Margaret Archbold. Nathan Audette. Elijah Awada. Fritz Bailey. Sid Veer Bakshi. Olivia Bardeen. Isabel Basurto Pofrel. Simon Baumberger. Marita Benick. Daniel Berhane. Olivia Bame. Oliver Bolin. Elias Bratman. Paige Bullis. William Burke. Samantha Burrows. Teresa Bystronova. Monica Calkins. Amari Carter. Theodore Casey. Minsuk Cho. Maxwell Christensen. Sophie Clausen. Jack Clipper. Asher Cohen. Bailey Coleman. Alexandra Connors. Cara Conrad. Hannah Conroy. Olivia Corcoran. Peter Countryman. Grace Coyle. Benjamin Craighead. Grace Kramer. Anna Maria Cullen. Thomas Cunningham. Joseph Check. Catherine Dario. Kira Davis. Lauren Davis. Kira DeGroot. Luigi D'Alessio. Natalie Diekman. Joseph Dietrich. Lauren Disher. Hien Do. Stella Dolan. Andrew Domler. William Domler. Elizabeth Doherty. Jacob Dunham. Jamel Edwards. Reese Engelmeyer. Isaac Enriquez Olvera. Olivia Esch. Hugh Fleming. Sophia Foldy Flynn. Chloe Franzen. Eleanor Fryer. Maxwell Fronda. John Gertner. John Gallus. Joshua Garcia. Carolyn Garcia Cretin. Olivia Garrity. Matthew Gleason. Nora Graff. Corbin Graham. Bianca Grassi Queto. Anne Green. John Greenheck. Ina Griffin. Jane Grumbles. Zion Guerra. Gabriel Gustin. Javon Hadley. Catherine Hannon. Hunter Hansen. Isabella Hansen. Hannah Hausman. James Hayes. Alex Hare. John Heisel. Samuel Hernandez. Natalie Hingsberger. Michael Holman. Emma Hansa. Devon Howell. Guys, this way. Jacob Hunt. Samantha Hewitt. Eleanor Jablonek. Anton Jackson. Cameron Jackson. Sydney Jackson. Ja'Kai James. Francis J. Zane Hoxson. Cal Johns. Aiden Johnson. Dalia Johnson. Isaac Johnson. Stephen Johnson. Lucille Johnston. Annabelle Jones. Curtis Jones. Olivia Kala. Maxwell Karras. Siobhan Keeley. Christina Kelly. Charlotte Kennedy Budge. Elise Kogan. Jake Kircher. Lyric Kokendorfer. Mary Kate Kasurik. Adam Koenig. Cody Konechny. Isabella Corzelius. Maxwell Kozer. Hayden Cruz. Caroline Kinster. Lucy Kulhanek. Cameron Lacasse. Henry Larson. Julian LeDuc. David Lemons. Joseph LaRue. Dominic Lewis. Jacques Lewis. Kenna Lexaw. Olivia Link. Robbie Lopez Mendez. Ian Machado. Monica Malloy. Michaela Matthews. Isabella McDonald. Daniel McGraw. Emily McQuillan. Megan McSherry. Grimawi Malake. Anna Mellum. Reed Menke. Dejane Mendez. Allison Myers. Nevea Maester. Carl Molnar. Ava Monticelli. Emmanuel Monrovia Tommy. Dominic Morales. Anastasia Morton. Nicole Metzel. Theodore Metzel. Elizabeth Murphy. Margaret Yusolf. Allison Neighbor. Jack Nye. Joseph Nemo. Justin Newhouse. Isabella No. Lan No. Julia Niklosky. Anthony Nissen. Carly Novak. Charles Oakes. Kira Obert. Jacob Odman. Harris Olander. Isabel Ostrom. Nicholas Owsley. Andrew Page. Charles Packes. Elizabeth Patterson. Jack Patwell. Paige Peltier. Jackson Peralt. Jackson Peters. Caroline Peterson. Jackson Pindred. Madeline Plash. James Reardon. Jack Redpath. Lillian Reed. Anna Rice. Ella Richards. Marcos Rivas. Tishara Rocket. Charles Rogers. Joseph Rahm. Elizabeth Rosemark. Raheem Ross. Anthony Rossini. Kira Ryan. Ethan Safi. Lauren Safi. Caduce Samuel. Mitch Savakul. Mia Scanlon. Zoe Shearer. Tyson Schilling. Chloe Schmidt. Emma Schuld. Michael Schwantes. Ryan Schwartz. Laura Seifert. Lauren Selbichka. Aldo Sevilla Arellano. Stephen Shaughnessy. Ethan Sigler. Joshua Sims. Allison Smith. William Soltis. Sydney Sommerfeld. Tanner Sterling. Matthew Stika. Benjamin Stringer. Christian Strahman. Anne Strong. Samuel Strong. Michael Stupka. Yo Wei Su. Annabelle Sullivan. Zachary Tallman. Sophia Tambornino. Travis Teeter. Preston Fellman. Ethan Thompson. Charles Tinty. Bridget Tierney. Xiao Chao Tai. Robin Tisdale. Jack Traxler. Anthony Underwood. Tyler Urban. Thomas Erdahl. Annika Van Ostrom. Aiden Vitek. Seamus Von Hayden. Christopher Walsh. Michael Walsh. William Wiegman. Luke Wells. Benjamin Wicker. Paige Wickland. Yu Xiao Wu. Jonathan Jakob. Thomas Zastrow. Cecilia Ziegler. I present to you the Cretin-Derham Hall Class of 2020. Students, please rise. Mr. Klein, will you please do the honors? The side exits, both sides, please. Congratulations, class of 2020.